Hello and welcome to PDFsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an IC693ALG390. This is an analog output, two channels, and its scale is negative 10 to positive 10 volt DC output. It's in an IC693CHS397 five slot rack, which is otherwise empty. It's being powered by an IC693PWR330 power supply. And the processor I'm using is an IC693CPU374+. So what we're going to talk about is how to test the ALG390 and how to configure it in Proficy Machine Edition. So in front of you right now, I have the processor in run mode. There's an option to use a 24 volt power supply. I'm not using that option. I've selected in Proficy Machine Edition not to have to need to do that. So in other words, I'm using the power from the backplane. In Proficy Machine Edition, I have the software configured the same way that you see the physical configuration in front of you. So I have the CHS397 five slot rack as my main rack. The PWR330 power supply, CPU374 central processor, and ALG390 in the slot number 2. So, if you open slot number 2 by double clicking on slot number 2, or you could right click on slot 2 and select configure, there's nothing really to configure on the ALG390. However, you do want to pay attention to where your reference address is, so that when you put a value into your analog output table, it's able to go to the proper destination and you're able to get a proper reading if the module's in good working condition. So what I've done is opened up a new file, a blank file, and it's automatically given me %AQ, which is analog output 0001. So my reference address starts on 0001 and will end on 0002, since this is only a two-channel output. Okay. Next, once that's configured, I'm going to go down to my reference view tables and expand that. Below that is default tables. You can expand that. And the second selection down is %AQ or analog output. You could either double-click on that or right-click and open. And then you're looking at your output table. The top right hand corner is where the addresses start at analog output 0001. And I've already placed a value of 32K or 32,000 in the in both addresses 001 and 2. And what I'm hoping to see is the full scale of the output. Channels 1 and 2 are located. Channel 1 is on terminals 3 and 5. That means the 3 would be positive, 5 is negative, or as they call it, common. Channel 2, 4 is positive, and 6 is negative, or common. So I'm going to place my terminals on channel number 1. And using a multimeter, I'm able to read my voltage, 10 volts DC, which is correct. And then I'm going to go to channel 2, again terminals 4 and 6, and again 10 volts. Now, another thing I do is I'll take the value, since this is not a digital, this is analog, so there's scale and range to it. I want to exercise some of that range. So I'll drop the value by half. And I'll put a value of 16,000 in. And now I'm getting a voltage reading of 5 volts. So that's correct. Half of 10 is 5. And then I'll go even further and put in a value of 8,000 and cut the 16,000 in half. And obviously the number I'm looking to read is 2.5 volts. And here I am getting exactly 2.5 volts. You could go all the way down 4,000, 2,000 if you want. Usually at this point I put in a zero and make sure that there is no value when I touch the terminals, and I have a perfect 0.000. And I do this on both channels to make sure that, again, that I'm exercising its full range of ability. to make sure it's a good working device and it's not simply just stuck in the full mode. So that's pretty much the entire test. The only other thing I could tell you, if the channels aren't operating at all, or if they give you a full value no matter what numerals you put into your output table, analog output table, or if the OK light is off, any of those three things would just constitute a bad module. And this is something that we do repair here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same-day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.